Welcome back to Nature Knows Best. Pollution is a big problem here on Earth. But have you ever heard of noise pollution? Trust me, working this job, we deal with noise issues all the time. See what I mean? But now, NASA is working on ways to help combat this problem.
And much of the work is being done inside this amazing dome.
Wow, Danielle, this is a spectacular place to do research.
I'm with Danielle Koch, an aerospace engineer who's working on reducing noise pollution created by airplane engines.
Inside this dome, there are no echoes. There are no echoes because the ceiling and the floors are all covered with these large wedges. If you could look inside these wedges, you'd see that they're filled with fiberglass, a manufactured material that's flame resistant, so that it's a safe environment to test this hot airplane engine.
So tell me more about noise pollution and why it's a problem.
Very loud sounds, particularly the sounds that you hear for a very long time, can damage your health. You can lose your hearing, have increased blood pressure, elevated heart rates.
So you're looking for ways to help change that and to fix the noise pollution problem.
Right. Whether you live in the suburbs or the cities, transportation noise is a big part of what people hear. The noise from cars, planes, buses, and trains all make it difficult for people to hear the beautiful sounds of nature all around us.
Danielle's path to this place resulted from an inspiring personal experience.
I was giving presentations at conferences all across the country. I happened to take a detour, and I visited my brother on vacation with my family. He lives in rural Oregon, and he took me on an adventure that eventually ended up on a single-lane road at the top of a mountain ridge, and I heard the sound I had never heard before. My first instinct was that I heard highway noise, but for the first time in my life, I heard the wind rushing over thousands and thousands of acres of forest in the wilderness. And I just really became motivated to reading more about natural materials and how they absorb sound and led us here today.
Lucky for us, Danielle and her group are testing an airplane engine today. Inside an airplane is quiet. But outside? Well, let's find out.
I can imagine it's really loud.
Absolutely, but first you have to put on this hearing protection.
All right, safety first.
Okay.
Here you go. So we're gonna go over here. Oh my gosh, that's so loud. Whoa. And that's not even full power, right? That's not the loudest that the engine can go.
Right. We have some work to do.
And much of that work is being inspired by nature. For instance, engineers have been studying owls to develop technology for quiet flight. And Danielle is working with other materials as well. For example, a honeycomb-like material.
Both bees and people have discovered that honeycomb is strong, lightweight shapes. And people are using it in airplane engines to reduce noise.
Then she showed me things you'd find in the ocean.
Yeah, it reminds me of pumice stone.
Yes, right. Or, you know, these are sea sponges, you know, but these are soft and squishy.
Another structure in nature that absorbs sound is reeds.
A research paper recorded an observation that bundles of these reeds absorb sound well in the low frequency range. Maybe we could someday put it inside an engine liner like this. Would you like to see or hear how well our prototypes are working today?
I would love to.
Danielle then shows me how the sound changes in a honeycomb liner as compared to the container with no liner.
Ooh. Ah, that's loud.
First, I put this speaker simulating airplane sounds in the liner without the honeycomb.
Okay, that was 80.4.
Let's try the second.
That was 72.4.
The difference between the container with no liner and the one lined with a honeycomb material was about 8 decibels. That's a 10% lower volume of noise. By using nature as an inspiration, NASA is finding ways to reduce noise pollution.
Well, this demonstration showed us that the decibels went down.
It did. It did. Actually, perforate over honeycomb is a hard act to follow. And this is just the beginning of our research journey. We're very hopeful that this technology might someday make its way onto an airplane, or perhaps in an automotive application, or even an architectural application. We're hoping that it makes life better for people.